Hello guys, hi everyone. Okay, I think you see me. So today I'm going to cook, I'm going to speak in English. So ce soir je vais parler en anglais, donc c'est le soir à Singapour, et je vais vous présenter une petite salade, donc healthy cooking, healthy millet salad with a nice steak, of course. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to change the screen and I will show you what I will use today to cook, and you will see straight away. Okay, let me check on this one. I think you can see now. Let me check if you are able to see the salad and the ingredient. I think it should be okay. And after this, I'm going to show you how to cook a nice grass-fed beef. Look at that. Look at how it's beautiful. Very nice. Okay, I think I will put double screen better so you can see me like that. I think here should be okay, no? Okay, yes. So let's start with the salad first. Okay, so as you can see, this one I use broccoli, yeah? Okay, a very nice broccoli, and what we call the millet. Okay, so millet actually is a grain that is gluten free. It's no gluten, and there is no it's very healthy. There is no lectin as well, so it's very very healthy. And then after this, I'm going to put some nice spinach, so fresh spinach like that. After this, croquette salad a little bit, and then I have some cherry tomato, a few. I have endives like that. Okay, and then broccoli, of course. So broccoli, what I did with the broccoli, I just cook it very fast. I just boil it. You can see the color is still very green, very nice. So I cook it very fast. I boil water. I put the broccoli. I wait until it's tender. Then after I make it dry, I put in the ice water first, and after I make it dry. So the thing is, like, if you do it steam, the color and the nutrient, we start to lose the power of the broccoli. So it's very important. You just cook fast, and it has to be still crunchy, crunchy, very crunchy. Okay, so I'm going to do a quick dressing. So I already chopped the garlic with a bit of olive oil here. So I chop garlic. After, straight away, I put the olive oil because the garlic become dark black very fast. So that's why you have to put some olive oil. Okay, then after this, I put some, as you can see here. I put some mustard, a little bit. I have not much, but this is enough. I will put some olive oil as well. Some more, so after we can test, because it's a bigger salad that I'm going to do, and I put a little bit of balsamic as well. So vinegar, balsamic, to give a bit of sweetness there. And then I have a fresh endive, so this I'm going to cut it in two, like that. If you can see, yes, correct. So I like the salad, the endives, because it's a little bit bitter. You know, in the bitter test, when you put some balsamic as well, balsamic is a bit sweet. So the texture together with the endives. The endives are very nice. Tomato I will not put all, endives I can put everything. So same, endives you can cook it as well. In English also we can, it is called wheat loaf. Yeah, I think it's wheat loaf, but French endive. So endives, the fresh endives, we can cook it as well. I like it baked in oven. You can a bit steam it and you can bake it with a nice piece of ham, bechamel, cream also around. But I like it fresh because fresh, you get all the nutrients from here. So very fresh is very nice as well. And then after I will just slice a few tomatoes inside. So I like the cherry tomato with a lot of color like that, really nice. Okay, that's the, we call the heirloom baby cherry tomato. So that's also very good. And after this, I will put a bit of spinach. So fresh spinach as well, like that. A roquette, I will put a little bit less. The roquette as well is a bit bitter. So I like to put a little bit inside, not too much. And then I will put a bit of millet, so fresh millet like that. So same millet, I don't put too much. But you know, for vegetarian, sometimes I eat only that. It's very good for vegetarian meal because you have no meat, and it's also a good nutrient inside. So here I put the broccoli as well. So that's a nice salad for 2 person, 3 person is enough. But you know, I like to eat a bit of steak, a nice every, today is Friday night. So let's do a good grass-fed meat, beef, steak that is going well together. Okay, broccoli, I love broccoli, so I put everything. That's really nice. After this, I put some, I didn't put salt on the dressing, so I just put some salt here. So I like to put the sea salt. So Guérande, sea salt from Guérande. And then black pepper a bit. Oh. Like that. So you can see a nice dressing. I will put a bit more balsamic and olive oil because the salad is quite big here. So same, for the olive oil, I'm using the extra virgin olive oil. Look at that, this one. This is very nice olive oil. It's called La Magnanerie. La Magnanerie is from France. So it's extra organic virgin olive oil. Very, very nice flavor, texture. Sometimes, of course, I'm using some Italian olive oil. Also extra virgin, sometimes Spanish, it all depends, but I like it the way it is. Okay, so I'm going to mix it, you can see here, yes. Okay, once again, I use a spoon, you can use your hand if you have plastic gloves, or try to wash your hand all the time. Because now hygiene is very, very, very strict. So we have to be careful in terms of hygiene, you know. So make sure that your place, your kitchen, even at home, you know, where you work, like your kitchen at home, I mean, it has to be very clean and you have to be safe all the time. So same when you are using knife, try to use knife and make sure that it's on the back of your chopping board so it's more safe for you. Okay, that's perfect. Look nice. So I do this salad. I do this salad very often. We love it with my wife. So this one, I don't need to test it because I know it's very good already. This thing is perfect. Fantastic, fantastic salad. Look at that. Very nice. The color is nice. Okay. So right now, I'm going to show you how to cook the steak. So there is a technique to cook the steak, and it's very simple. But when you are at home, thing that you have to cook fast and easy. Don't make it too complicated. So when you cook, you see a salad like this, I pre-cook before I pre-cut. I mean, I prepare a little bit everything, but it take about 20 minutes to do it, and the steak, same, it's very fast. So when you make a meal, it will take you about 40 minutes, 45 minutes, or less than that, and you already have very good food here. Okay, so I leave the salad like this. I'm going to show you the steak first. So this one, look at that. So the grass-fed, I always like to take grass-fed beef because it's more healthy. And you know that beef, that eating grain are not really good, because you know you are what you eat and you are what the food has been eaten, you know. So like if the food has been, like the beef has been eaten grain, is actually you going to eat grain as well. So in a long term, you will get like lectin, what we call lectin. And if you have too much lectin in your body, your gut cannot digest. So your intestine, everything cannot digest it properly. So when you have a nice grass-fed meat, grass-fed beef, this is perfect. So sometimes I eat meat now less. So this steak we're going to eat for two people today, tonight with my wife. So we eat, I eat now two times a week meat. So like one time will be beef, sometimes chicken during the week. But I try to be more into vegetable now and vegetarian. But I still like meat, of course, because, you know, since you are young, when you grow up, we always grow up with meat. So if you change straight away to become a vegetarian, your body cannot take it. So like you have to grow gradually. But for me, I still like the taste of the meat, the texture. So it's very nice. So it's good taste. Okay, I'm going to show you. Come with me. Okay, I just go at the back. I'll show you from the back one. I change my camera side like that. Yes, you can see here. Yeah, perfect. Let me move a little bit like that. Okay, good. Perfect. So, what I use to cook the beef, you can see I use butter. Okay, so of course I'm French, I like butter. And I forget to put salt and pepper, sorry. I'm going to show you here, salt and pepper. So, I like to put salt before I start to cook on the beef, like that. So I put everywhere, and I will put pepper also. And I put thyme and rosemary when I cook it together. Put a bit of salt. This one, show you that you can see. Yeah, perfect. Okay, and you know, don't forget, you click like to my channel. And on Facebook, because now we are live on YouTube, on Facebook, sorry. So you click like and I send you the recipe straight away, okay? But you have to show me that you click like. Okay. So, I like induction actually is good, but I like to use the real fire, you know, for the steak, because you can manage it better. But now we use, because we are at home, so we have to use with what we have. So induction is not too bad. It's very fast. It's the heat actually come very fast. You can see. So I like to put a little bit of oil at the beginning. I put some oil on the pan. You can see that? Yeah. And then I will put some butter as well. So now on maximum. So the technique is, to make your batter brown color. If your batter is too white before you put the steak, when you put the steak and your batter is still white, you know it's not brown color, not burn, but brown, just nicely brown. Then your steak gonna boil it inside the white batter. So that's why it's very important to make a nice brown batter until the color is look like a hazelnut, you know. We call it noisette in French. Then when it's a nice color like that, starting to be very nice color, brown, then you add in your steak. Okay, you hear that? This is what you need to hear. That's the song of the steak cooking. This is the correct way. Okay, so after that, you can lower a little bit the fire. We play a bit with the fire. As a, it's an induction, you can just remove it, the pan around. But the color still needs to be nice on top, nicely brown. Then you put some thyme and rosemary on top. And be careful when you put the thyme because you see. And it's a lot of smoke. So what I'm going to do, a little bit exhaust. So I will speak a little bit louder. Look at the color now. We have to be crunchy. You see, crispy on top, but not burnt. And as a French, we like it rare. Then I like to put some garlic a little bit. So I put some garlic, sometimes I just put the whole garlic or I cut it through like this and I let it cook together. You can see that, that's very nice. We put the salad in the fridge. Yeah, keep the salad always in the fridge because the weather in Singapore is really hot. You can see, look at that. Okay, now we have a nice medium rare steak. Almost medium rare now. Okay, so you see what I will do straight away is I will put the steak on a tissue paper, okay? So like that, and I will let it rest. Okay, now you can hear. So I will let it rest for So you can see the color, nice, nice steak. This is perfect like that. So you know it's always to let the blood go out. You can put on the paper like that, and you leave it for. You leave it for 5 minutes. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to show you on a big screen right now. Let me put the big screen for you. Yes. Okay. So now you can, I think you can see me right now. Okay. So you can see beautiful color of the steak. I will just put like that. Okay, I will put back like this so you can see. Look at this, very nice. Okay. I will go back with the salad to show you. Here is a dish. So tonight, nice salad, nice steak, and enjoy. Bon appétit. Have a good Friday, everybody. Have a good Friday night, and I see you soon. I see you. I will do on Friday. Usually, I do on every Friday. I do a cooking video, and then on Saturday, probably next Saturday, I will do a surprise for you. Special menu with a special ingredient that you don't see quite often. Okay, so I see you soon and bye bye. See you guys.